So, good morning on a lovely Wednesday morning. It is currently 5:37 a.m. and it's time to do the MG ZS-EV's winter range test. So, at the moment I'm currently charging on an Engini charger. I know you probably shouldn't be doing this rapid charging at 95% just to top up, but there is no one here and it's 5 in the morning, so that shouldn't be a problem. It's 1 degree. It's about 6 mile an hour wind, and we're going to head towards IKEA in Leeds and then come back. That should cancel out any sort of headwind gain or tailwind reduction in range. So I'm going to set a couple ground rules. So first of all, I'm going to be trying to use the active cruise control as much as I can and MG Pilot. The main reason why is because it should keep the speed as consistent as it can as well. I'm doing this quite early in the morning for two reasons. One, it's the actual temperature. As I said, it's 1 degree. So that's fairly wintry conditions as it goes. Another ground rule I am setting is I have, as a result, because I've had to drive to the rapid charger, it's about 3 or 4 miles from my house. I have obviously preheated the cabin and I'm using heated seats. I'm going to try and put it on the two or three bar heat, depending on how hot I get in the car. Just to keep myself comfortable. Realistically, the heater in this car is pretty good, so that means you don't have to keep it on too much of a high heat. Another thing I am switching on is the air conditioning to dehumidify the cabin. I don't think it's particularly that useful because I am heating the cabin, but I'm gonna make sure that none of the windows fog up. I'm literally just topping up here and let's get started. So I am gonna be doing a time lapse again with this camera. Hopefully it doesn't run out of battery at any point. I'm not quite sure whether you can plug it in while recording, so let's find out on that one. So I'm just going to quickly reset the trip computer. So this is what I've been doing in terms of the month of January. I know it's the 5th of Feb, but I've just completely forgot to reset the trip. So as you can see, I have been sat in the car for quite a lot. My average speed has been pretty poor. So apart from the drive back up to the south, and I did visit the Yorkshire EV Club's meet at Meadowhall last month. So apart from that, I've been sort of pootering around town. So that's why my average speed's pretty poor. So let's reset the trip by holding down. So that's reset. I'm also going to reset this one. So at the moment, it's not fully charged yet, but it's indicating a range of 130 miles. I am going to put it into normal mode because that gives me a much more realistic range, I think, on the motorway at least. If we go to tyre pressure, as you can see, it's 37.7 psi. It has got a bit colder since I've actually pumped up the tyres. So hopefully, I have been hauling a lot of stuff around, hence why the tyre pressures are a little bit higher. So I just thought I would mention that before I start this journey, I am going to be listening to a couple of podcasts, and the chosen podcast that I'm going to be listening to at least is the one from EV Musings and made by Gary C. I actually met the guy at the Yorkshire EV meet down at Meadowhall on the 26th of January. And he mentioned the podcast, and I've actually been listening to a couple and they're extremely informative. I think at the moment, the most important thing that a lot of electric car owners who decide to talk about their electric vehicle should be doing at the moment is, as I completely agree with Gary, is changing the narrative. Kudos to Gary, and I will be listening to a couple podcasts on my range tests. So thank you very much. we've just reached Batley, the turning point on the journey. I'll just throw out a couple of stats to you. So, at the moment, the vehicle has done an average speed of 62 miles an hour, 58.4 miles over 55 minutes. The trip computer is saying 2.6 miles per kilowatt hour. That's quite poor, actually. I've not really sort of experienced that before, although bear in mind I haven't driven it when it's been this cold before. As you can see, we're on the lovely smart motorway network, and the top speed at the moment is 60 miles an hour, which is absolutely brilliant. So that was the turning point. I will set my sat nav to go back to Hull, but as far as I'm aware, we're going to make it, no problem at all. 66 miles range remaining, so we're going to probably have about 10-15 miles to spare by the end. Alright then, so I will see you in Hull, hopefully. Thank you. actually just plugged in the car. It was at 6%, but as the car was faffing around with all the menus and things, so total distance was 115.2 miles, an average of 57 miles an hour. Total hours, 2 hours, 2 minutes, and 2.9 miles per kilowatt hour. At the moment, I'm currently getting the battery voltage is 396 volt with a current of around 110 amps. So I'll also write down what that kind of equates to. So 7%, as far as I'm aware, if I just do a bit of napkin maths using those stats, bear in mind that it did get significantly slower on the way back as I hit rush hour sort of in Hull. But if we do the maths, I think it checks out to be 122 miles to proper empty. That's pretty reasonable. The thing is it sort of fluctuated between about 1 degree and minus one. Apart from that, to be honest with you, that's, you know, for this time of year, at the end of the day, you're probably not going to be doing 70 miles an hour all over the place, especially as ice starts forming. So, yeah, that's what I would kind of expect. So, be sure to like this video, subscribe for some more if you're not already subscribed, and I'll see you next time.